Okay, so now I'm on to the standard electrode potentials of the redox equilibria. So, each half cell is a redox half equation, and all redox equations are reversible. All reversible reactions, we should know this from Unit 2, follow Le Chatelier's principle, and this is that they'll be affected, and the equilibrium will shift to oppose changes in temperature, concentration, and pressure. Half cells are also, though, affected by the current, and that's just because it's a flow of electrons, which is electricity, and obviously current is a factor, but you don't need to know that much detail. So, to calculate the standard electrode potentials, we need to use something, and what we use is the standard hydrogen electrode. By standard, we mean standard conditions, and that's zero current, 1 mole per decimeter cubed, 298 Kelvin, which is also 25 degrees Celsius, and 100 kilopascals, which is also 1 atmosphere. Right, so the standard hydrogen electrode, well, is given a value, an E value, of 0. 0 volts, because obviously it's an EMF. Diagrammatically, the standard hydrogen electrode, the half cell, has a platinum electrode. It's got hydrogen gas, which is bubbled in, and the solution is hydrogen plus ions, H plus ions, and obviously the salt bridge, because on the other side will be another electrode potential. So, within a cell, you can kind of tell from the diagram, but the standard hydrogen electrode is always on the left. The reason we do this is because the E value is zero, so that makes the E cell equal the electrode potential of the right. So there you go, straight up, we've got the value for the standard electrode of whatever's on the right. And that's it for the standard electrode potentials for the redox equilibria.